Hello everyone, thank you very much for watching this video. This is to answer a question from Peter. Thank you very much for the question about the ternary operator. Is it possible to call methods instead of having static values? The answer is yes, you can do that. So let's get into an example on how to do that and how it works. And also discuss later a little bit about how you could do the same thing with the switch expression starting with Java 14. And if we have an X and an Y, for example, in your question you mentioned the addition and multiplication, so let's have add and the multiply method. For example, here I would say static int add, and I receive the parameters X and Y, and the method of course adds X and Y, so returns X plus Y. And I need a second method, multiply, and X and Y as well in this case, and I return X and Y multiplied. So yes, I need them to be static just because I call them from main, which is static as well. So if I wouldn't declare them static, then I can't call them. This is of course not related to using them in the ternary operator or something like that. They are just two simple methods. You could have two normal methods like behavior of different instances, or like these two static methods. This was the easiest way to do it now. And of course I get a result, and in the result I will just have to use a condition for the ternary operator, let's say X greater than Y. Then I have the question mark, which is by the syntax of the ternary operator, also known as Elvis operator. And instead of returning a static method, of course I call add and say I add X and Y. And in case X is not greater than Y, then I call multiply and I multiply the two values. And you can do something like that, and you can see this is basically how it looks like. The important thing to take into consideration here is that of course the methods have to return a value. You can't use void methods. So that would be a good thing to know, especially for a question in the OCP 11 exam. Because that's where you will find several situations in which code snippets from the questions have syntax errors, and then the entire code doesn't compile. For the ternary operator, you have to mind that the methods need to return a value, and then you have to be very careful where you take the value, what's the type of the variable, because in this case I can use an int, being that both my methods return an int here. But for example, say I would change one of them and I would make it return a double, then I can't use an int anymore here, because one of the methods returns an int and the other returns a double. The only way I can solve this problem is by using a super type that matches both of the values, which for example it might be object. Or if you are using, of course, Java 10 or above, let's say you are attending the OCP 11 exam, then you can as well use the var word, and then the variable will take a type according to the expression you put on the right side of the equals operator, and this will work the same as choosing yourself the correct type. And you can see the value here in my console, so the execution returned, printed in the console, the value 200, which is actually Y multiplied with X, because in my case X is 10, so it's not greater than Y, then it simply executed the multiplication here. It entered the multiply method, returned the value, and then the value was returned and assigned to the result variable and printed in the console. Okay, you can do the same thing. I will comment this out now, and you can do something similar. Let's not call it the same thing. It's not the same thing. It's different. It's a different syntax, but you should take also into consideration that the switch expression, the switch expression which entered the language with version 12, but was released as general available in version 14, which is actually the latest version of Java at the moment of recording this video. You can do this something very similar. Let's say you have a Z and this variable has a value, then you can take the result and use a switch expression and try something like this. If your z is 100, then you want to add x and y. If it's 200, then you have to multiply them. And of course, always with the switch expression, you need to use a default and say what happens for any other situation. Let's say we decide to throw an exception here, or yeah, if you don't want to throw an exception, maybe just return a static value in this case. So something like this. Again, they have to have the same type, or you have to use a specific proper value, otherwise it won't compile, like in my case here, because multiply still returns a double. It can't be used here because I specified that I want to take the result in an int variable. So let's use something that actually can take both of the values, like letting the language decide the type. And then I can print the result so you can see what happens. So I print the result, and of course, being that z is 100, it matches this case. We'll call the addition and we'll return a 30 in my case. The value decided to be actually a double, as you can see here, because indeed double can keep the value of an int and a double as well. So it's enough. It has enough precision to keep both values, so that's why double works as well here. Previously I gave you the example with object again, which is something that that you could use, being a super type or a type that can hold both values in my case. So this is it. This is how it's working with the ternary operator, or something similar like you have from a general available for version 14, like the switch expression. And you can use methods as well. You can call them instead of having values. And basically, you might even do that in general in real world situations rather than returning static values. So it's I would say that it's even more probable that you will find situations rather calling methods that do something than putting your very static values for the results of either the ternary operator or the switch expression. I hope this answers your question. You will also have the code on my GitHub account and the link for the code in the comment section and in the description of the video. Thank you very much for asking the question, and have a great time for studying.